In this video, I'm going to be looking at the configuration of a motor turbo repeater for Capacity Plus. So let me get a code plug here which has got the Capacity Plus feature enabled. So I've got a repeater here, DR3000. It has a relatively, well, a new firmware version in it. It's a UHF. And more importantly, it has got Capacity Plus being listed as purchased. You may have a repeater where this is shown as free. If you do, it's one of the first repeaters that we launched, which when we launched Capacity Plus, we gave some Capacity Plus licenses for free. So if you've got free, then you've got a very unique repeater. Now, some things are new here. Firstly, there are some settings here which relate to linked Capacity Plus. We're not concerned about linked Capacity Plus, so the stuff that's related to linked Capacity Plus, I'm going to skip it for now. Okay. So, radio name. I need to give this a radio name, so a name, site name, something memorable, something that I can say, okay, well, this is this box here. Radio ID, this has to be unique. This has to be a unique number on the system. So here I've got one. So it means that you cannot have a radio out there in the field which has got the same radio ID. It has to be unique. And this is very specific to phone patch. Site ID and site alias I'm not interested in. The rest of the fields, this is up to you. You can go and read through the manual and understand what all of these other things mean. Accessories, I'm not too worried about. Privacy, I'm going to leave it as none. If you want to, you can put whatever privacy in your system as you like. Networking, I need to change some things here. Now, although this repeater is on the same site as the other repeaters, it's a single site system, Capacity Plus, we still need to do some settings relating to IP, and this stuff is set over here. On the site, we need to set one repeater to be the master repeater. So this one, I'm going to have it as the master. The next one on, you would set it as the peer, but anyway. So it's the master, and we need to put in the IP address. So 192.168.1.1. The master repeater needs to have a static IP address. That is clear. You have to do that. UDP port 50,000, leave it as it is. There's no reason for you to change it. Ethernet IP again. This is the IP address of this repeater on the network. So again, I just copy this from master IP, which is 192.168.1.1. Gateway IP. This is the IP address of my router. Well, if we wanted to, we could have a router on our site. But, well, this is a single site system, so I'm not really interested in about routing traffic through the other network. So I just put in some dummy value there. Gateway net mask. 255.255.255.0, that's okay. IP site connect, I'm not worried about. REST channel site IP, here this stuff I'm not worried about. You can leave it as it is. IP repeater programming, if you want to, you can access this repeater remotely and do some configuration changes. Sites talk groups, this is something specific to linked Capacity Plus. We're here, we're only talking about single site Capacity Plus, so this you can skip. Now it comes down to the channel. I need to go and I need to add in a Capacity Plus voice channel. So there's it there, channel one. Let's remove this one. We're not interested in linked Capacity Plus. So I've only got one channel here, channel one, and this is my Capacity Plus channel. How do I know it is? Because when I added it, I said add Capacity Plus voice channel. Also, you can tell by the little icon over here next to it. It's like little C plus, and it's got these little waves and the 101. This tells me that it can parse voice and data, and it's a Capacity Plus channel. If we look at the settings here, we have color code. That's color code, we know that already. RSSI threshold, this is the threshold set for the FCC type 1 compliance. I like to set this for at least minus 80 dBm. Preference level, I like to set this, leave this at 1. If you want to, you can change it, but make them all the same. Whatever you want to put in, make them all the same. The only time that you want to make some repeaters different is if you're using a phone patch. Slot 1 channel ID, slot 2 channel ID. This is the virtual channel number, as it were. So here I've got 1 and 2. On the next repeater, what I would do is I'd put that to be 3 and 4 and 5 and 6. So as I'm changing this one is changing too. So this one is 1 and 2. We can have up to, as you can see there, 6 repeaters on the site. Each repeater has 2 slots, so 2 slot channel IDs. So that is the repeater configuration for Capacity Plus. This would be the configuration of the master. Let me go back and show you what we would change, what would be different in the peer. So first up, general settings. Here I would put something which I can remember, so another name. It has to have a unique radio ID, so this can be true. Site ID, site alias I'm not interested in. Accessories I'm not interested in, privacy I'm not interested in, network I'd need to change some things here. Now this is no longer, we can't have two masters on at the same time, so this one has to be a peer. What is the IP address of the master? It's that was already set in the master. What is the IP address of this repeater now, of this peer repeater, repeater number 2? Well, we would define that, we'd have a static IP address, or if you have a DHCP server on the site, you can just simply tick DHCP. Most likely you don't have a DHCP server, in which case you need to put in a unique IP address here. Sites, I'm not interested in. Talk groups, I'm not interested in. Then coming down to the channel, obviously the frequencies would have to be unique. So let's put in a frequency. Oops, .525. Copy, that's fine. Color code, the same. RSSI threshold, the same. Preference level, the same. But since now this is the second repeater in the list, the second repeater in the site, it would be slot 1 channel ID 3, slot 2 channel ID 4. So if you have these two repeaters, the master and the peer, the master has got slot 1 channel ID 1 and 2, and this one has got 3 and 4. But then if you had a third one, it would be 5 and 6, and a fourth one 7 and 8, all the way up to 12, if you had that many channels on the site. What you can do, of course, is you can change the name of this channel. So right button click, rename, and we can call this perhaps, say, channel 2. So it's looks nice in RDAC. That is the configuration of the repeater.